After the Hello again, guys. It is I, Freeze700. We are back with some Warhammer 40k lore. This time, what is the Ordo Minoris faction known as the Ordo Machinum? Well, to start with, the Ordo Machinum is an Ordo Minoris that is focused on monitoring the mechanics. That is right. This is a Ordo of Inquisitors that is specifically designed to overwatch and observe and really regulate the Mechanicus. Now, this conflicts a lot with certain ideas in your head that might already be popping up in the comments section. Like, well, why would a government body be needed to overwatch another government body? This is really stepping on each other's toes here. Well, to start with, the Mechanicus is actually a separate entity. In fact, it's more of an empire that exists within another empire. So, despite the fact that the Mechanicus has close ties and almost the same origins as the Imperium and shared thousands of years together, they're actually two separate entities. But their fates are so entwined that should one empire fall, the other one is going to fail too. Should one empire succeed, the other empire will feel the benefits. So it's really in both their interests to always work together and to really make sure that nothing happens between the two. Now, that being said, since the Treaty of Olympus Mons, or also known as the Treaty of Mars, gives Mars freedom to operate as a sovereign entity in the Imperium and not be directly ruled over, this gives the Mechanicus a lot of freedoms. But this freedom is not really something that the Imperium likes to hear. So while they are allowed to be independent, they could choose when to send their forces, they could choose whether or not they want to help the Imperium by giving them this new air conditioning unit, they do have to follow some rules and laws. After all, they do share Imperial space. So they have to adhere to some laws, like tithes. So they do have to give stuff. They do have to pay a little tax for owning all this shit. But they also reap benefits, too. Like being able to travel anywhere in the Imperium without having to say so or fill out a form. No, they could just go out and do it. Now, despite the Mechanicus aiding the Imperium with technology, the Mechanicus itself is kind of prone to some human flaws, like hoarding technology or implementing useless technology that is terrible as fuck, is flawed design, it's flawed understanding, it's just bad. So this is kind of where the Ordo Machinum fills that role. This Ordo ensures that there is an oversight into how much relics and tech the Mechanicus is hoarding and is relieved of. So in other words, when an Imperial Tithe hits a Mechanicus Forge world and they go, alright, we're going to take 6,000 plasma guns from you, the Ordo Machinum can step in and go, whoa, step that back there, you got your numbers wrong. Don't do that because the Mechanicus is very pissy when you step on their toes like that. This is their tithe. This is what they owe us. Get the numbers correct. But at the same time, the Ordo Machinum is also the ones who will look at the Mechanicus and go, listen, I know you went on an archaeological dig. I know you took more than what you said you took. Cough it up, buddy. So that's where the Ordo Machinum lies. They're more of like the diplomats between the two factions. This is where the Ordo Machinum is, personally, to me, the most interesting job. Now, they're kind of the most boring out of all the Inquisitors because there are Inquisitors who are meant for fighting. There are Inquisitors who are meant for, like, investigations. These guys are just more paper pushers. Diplomacy. That's more their role. Their role is to more or less get into the Mechanicus, make ties, learn certain factions of the Mechanicus. Because, mind you, the Mechanicus is one group, but that one group has several thousands of splinter groups in it. In fact, the Mechanicus can vary wildly in their beliefs depending which Mechanicus you're talking to. Even the ones on Mars, each city is totally different in their beliefs and doctrines compared to the next city. So when you talk to a Mechanicus group all the way out on some bumfuck planet known as Calibri 6, it's going to be totally different to the Mechanicus on the absolute other side of the galaxy, on, like, Genital Warts 39. Like, you really don't know what the fuck these guys are going to believe. So this is why this Ordo Machinum has a really tough responsibility in managing all this diplomacy. Now, despite managing and doing diplomacy, this Ordo also is more responsible for managing what tech is acceptable to be implemented into the Imperium. So if the Mechanicus gave out a new plasma rifle design, they're like, whoosh, take this, Imperium, this will help you. Well, the Imperium won't take them in yet. They have one more step to complete, which is they have to pass the Inquisitor's inspections, and that will be the Ordo Machinum. Now, when the Ordo Machinum looks at these plasma rifles, they're going to run a lot of tests. And a few of these tests include things like, will the weapon be good enough for battle? Is it going to explode after so many shots? Is it more of a hindrance to the wielder because it weighs so much? Because, mind you, the Mechanicus, they're mostly machines, so if the weapon weighs 50 pounds, they wouldn't really give a fuck. Whereas a human, they'll give a fuck. Also things like, you know, is the weapon too powerful? Because last thing we need is for a world to rebel with these plasma guns, and our space marines are just getting fucking annihilated by plasma gun fire. So, whew, we gotta take that into consideration. But also, the most important factor, I think, is how much resources does it take to build this damn thing? Because plasma guns are already tough to make. And if this costs more resources, and it's not that big of a difference from our plasma guns we have now, let's just keep it the way it is. So these are some of the tests that they have to go through. That being said, this process could take a varying amount of time. This could take from a year to a few years to maybe even decades, even a century. Because depending on what kind of thing it is that they're trying to implement, could take more than one branch of the Ordo Machinum to really look at. So despite doing these things, the Ordo Machinum also does a lot of other shit. One of the things also includes going along with the archaeological digs that the Mechanicus runs. This is more or less done as a way of spying on the Mechanicus, making sure that their reports are totally accurate when they say that they've only found, four or five Necron skull heads to do research on. When reality is, they didn't get just four or five Necron skulls to do research on. They actually got Necron fucking death beams. They got all sorts of shit. They got a bunch of beetles. So yeah, this is where those agents go along with the dig sites to just fact check the reports and go, whoa. Stop hoarding there, guys. This is what you actually took. This is what we got to file. So that way you guys are taxed appropriately. Stop trying to dodge your taxes. Now, the Ordo Machinum also needs to go along in case they cite something that's a little alien or foreign or chaotic even. This is why this Ordo Machinum has really close ties working with the Ordo Xenos. The Ordo Xenos will look at a weapon and go, yep, that's a Xeno weapon. Don't even try researching it or else we're going to blast your ass. Now, some alien tech, as some of you may have known, usually falls into two categories. It's either too advanced to research, and that's the tech that they usually keep, like Necron heads or Eldar weapons. But then there's the other category, which is tech not worth replicating. And that's usually orc tech. Some Tau equipment is actually not worth it. Like the Tau plasma guns, the Imperium could make it. They understand, the Mechanicus does know how to make them. The issue is, though, is that they require a little bit extra resources, and also the power that they pack is not essentially any different than what the Imperium has. So there's really not any need to really replicate it. It's just more resources for a gun that's slightly better. Nothing amazing. So this is kind of where the Mechanicus stands. Now, despite that, I think this is very interesting to note that when these archaeological digs are found, it's usually the Ordo Xenos who usually pins the location and goes, hey, we just killed this Tau world. It's open for one of your archaeological dig sites. And that's when the Mechanicus goes, doing, cyber dong. We're going to go there and raid their fucking toasters, boys. And that's when the Ordo Machinum also gets a ping, doing. Hey, just make sure these guys don't, you know, jizz all over everything and then take something that's actually illegal to have. And it's like, okay, dude, we'll go with them. We'll make sure that they, you know, keep their cyber dongs under control. Now, that being said, how does someone get into the Ordo Minoris, known as the Ordo Machinum? Well, to get into it, you have to be just an Inquisitor, which already is kind of a tough feat. You have to be very intelligent, very loyal, have to pass all their trials and tests, have to be of aid to an Inquisitor for a lot of years before you're even apprenticed by him. But then it breaks down into other stuff. So in your Inquisitor career, you're going to have a lot of close ties with the Mechanus, and there's a big reason for that. The Mechanus is very, very isolationist. They're kind of xenophobic of other people. So they're not just xenophobic of aliens, they're also xenophobic of outsiders. So when it comes to getting in with the Mechanus, for them to report to you, for them to talk to you, for them to even accept you, that's very tough. In fact, there's been many run-ins with the Mechanus having full-on fights and battles against the Inquisition for the Inquisition stepping on their toes. Like, for instance, a Fabricator General could have accidentally invented something that's a little heretical. And one Puritan Inquisitor could say, I'm a sermonass that should have you, buddy. And the moment he gets involved with his little private army against the Mechanus, this is where things get a little rough. See, the Mechanus doesn't like being pushed around. They know their rights. They know their liberties. They know that they're allowed to police themselves. They actually do have their own separate branch that polices internally. So for an outsider to come in and do the police's job for them, that's pissing them off. That's you overstepping your boundaries in their eyes. Now, they could totally be in the wrong. Their leader could have totally done something illegal, and the cops are just not doing anything about it. That's totally possible. But the issue is that this is already a bit of a tenuous situation where the last thing you want is for this to be a full-on brawl. So this is where the Ordo Machinum kind of comes into play. Now, I'm not saying that the Ordo Machinum works all the time. There's always times where the Inquisition will overstep their boundaries and not consult the Ordo Machinum. And there are times where an Inquisitor just happens to fall upon something that's highly heretical, and he just has to take it into his hands to deal with. Well, the Ordo Machinum, this is why their whole career is based on just working closely with the Mechanus. Because if the Mechanicus doesn't like outsiders, and they've already had a few bad run-ins with the Inquisition, they're going to be a little hesitant to work with you. Now, that being said, there's a lot of benefits for them working with the Ordo Mechanicus. I mean, Ordo Machinum, my bad. Now, you may think, well, what benefits could there be? Well, that Inquisitor might decide to not report to his superiors that you accidentally scavenged, oh, I don't know, 3 bolter guns? Hey, I didn't see it. You didn't see it. I don't know what you're talking about. But there's also other things to it. Like, if another Inquisitor starts stepping on their toes, they could always say, well, here's this Inquisitor. He outranks you. Go talk to him while we're doing this. And then that Inquisitor will have to talk to you, and you'll clear his ass up and say, listen, stop pissing in my cereal. Go somewhere else. I got this. This is my investigation. I know what I'm doing. There's a few other things I think is very interesting about the Ordo Machinum, is that while they play a very pivotal role as diplomats, they also play a more pivotal role in ensuring that the Mechanicus doesn't overstep their boundaries. So besides that, this has been Freezer 700. I hope you guys enjoyed. Please click the subscribe button if you haven't subscribed already. But besides that, I hope you guys enjoyed. Comment down below what you guys think. Comment down below if you guys learned something new. I really hope there's more lore that we get published about the Ordo Machinum. Maybe we see them actually fighting the Mechanicus because they're actually wrong on an issue. Maybe we'll see some more, like, maybe the Ordo Machinum decides to fight with another Inquisition army because the Inquisition's kind of overstepping their bounds. I would love to see some of that. But besides that, this has been Freezer 700. I'm out. See you guys next time.